Scott's trying to stop horrible pop music coming out of his laptop. Alright? Still going. He's putting in headphones in now. Stop it. Alright, how is everyone? Yeah? Alright. So, we'll get started, I think, with a little bit of inspirational viewing for you all. UDS, this wonderful group of people had soul as well. So who was the last UDS? Yeah? The great group of people. And of course it's important for us to remember that these people do. These people were at the last release parties. 105 release parties around the world. Look at all these wonderful people. Filled with soul. We've got people from Russia, Cameroon. And here's Scott's laptop again. the pervasive sound of the cheeky girls. I think we've got Vancouver, we've got Dublin, I'm sure California, I'm sure some of you will see yourselves there. Of course, we've got these people as well, full of soul, from Massachusetts. He's here, where are you? There he is, Mark. I don't know who those people are. David, everyone knows David for the wrong reasons. Cookie, look at all these people. So, today, this week, we come here to make this guy happen. And there's only one person who can best direct us in that particular forefront, so march of the way.
All right, good morning, everybody. I have the enviable task of just trying to get the ball rolling and to see some ideas about what we want to be talking about this week. The schedule that we've got is absolutely fantastic. Thanks very much to the track leads. Who have put it together as the product of lots of conversations. But the Karmic Koala will actually only be formed this week. So the next 5 minutes are really just my cunning plan to try to shape the conversation, give you guys an idea of the key things that I think we can achieve in 9.10. So starting with the desktop, there is a session called Social from the Start, where what we're going to be talking about is bringing in social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Identica, microblogging, web of trust type media into the desktop from the very beginning. So thinking about how that's going to affect the install process, how that's going to affect the upgrade process, what it's going to be like effectively to start bringing those social web applications into the desktop, taking advantage of some of the infrastructure we already put in there in 9.04, looking at some of the cool new tools like Webber that we can integrate and figuring out how that all relates to Ubuntu 1. So that's going to be really interesting. The desktop experience work that went into 9.04 gets from the Ayatana project. Where's We're at Ted Gould and Mirka Mula. Okay, so notifications and messaging, and the messaging indicator, those things are going to get a rev, and there'll be a bunch of sessions about that. Cody Russell, where's Cody? Right at the back. Cody is going to be leading some sessions on GTK and how we can elevate the capabilities of the theming engine and how we can take advantage of that. How many of you guys are interested in graphical boot? All right, so the goal is for 9.10 to have a fully graphical boot and to do it really, really fast. Where's Scott? Scott says we can do it in 10 seconds. I say 12 seconds would be fine as long as it's pretty. we'll be integrating KMS, and there's lots of sessions here about whether we should use Plymouth or whether we should use Flash to KMS, what our various options are over there. And it is going to be shiny and beautiful and very, very fast. Who's interested in Android? All right, so there'll be some sessions, I think, on Android on Ubuntu, bringing Android to the full desktop experience, trying to make sure that we can take advantage of the great developer community that's forming around Android and find a way to bring the best of the mobile world to the free software desktop. On the server side, where's Rick Clark, your server track lead? So I can't do justice to all of the things that the server guys are going to talk about, but the things that I'm particularly interested in. The first is power management. I'm really keen that we figure out how to take advantage of all of the awesome suspended resume work that the kernel team's been doing and bring that to the server environment. People talk about green computing. Well, there's no better way effectively to reduce your wattage than to put a server that's not being used to sleep. And there's no better way to allocate resources than using sort of the elastic computing and cloud computing approach. So where's Team Eucalyptus? Team Eucalyptus is here. One, two. I thought there were two.
There's a couple more.
Okay, all right. So Eucalyptus guys are shy. Either that or they found the coffee. So we'll be building on the work that Chuck Short did for Ubuntu on EC2. EC2 is now going to be a first-class target. We'll have Ubuntu on EC2 releases on time, together with the rest of the various platforms and environments that we support for 9.10, 10.04, and 100. And of course, Eucalyptus, the Ubuntu Enterprise Cloud powered by Eucalyptus, that's going to see a big rev as it moves to main in 9.10. Building on top of that, we want to create a general framework for appliances. So we want to create a really simple way for people to build their own appliances so that you can quickly bring your applications up on that cloud. And those appliances have to be built to scale effectively. They have to take advantage of the architecture, the unique architecture of EC2 and UEC. Okay, moving on, Ubuntu 1. So congratulations to the Ubuntu 1 team, who I thought did a very smooth beta and very smooth launch. This is not without its controversy, and I think it's important that we take the opportunity here to talk through the various issues that this raises. Ubuntu 1, the design of Ubuntu 1 is not in any way accidental. Wow. Somebody hacked the AP system. Somebody call Ghostbusters. So Ubuntu 1 will move into the normal Ubuntu desktop, become part of the experience, and this is our opportunity to make sure that we set the right tone, we set the right direction, and do that in an elegant way that is aligned with our values. There's been a lot of community commentary on bug 385, 345, something like that, where people are talking about exactly what the right ways to do that are. But this is important for Ubuntu. This is, to my mind, what Ubuntu was from the start has been part of the sustainability strategy of Ubuntu. It is it's an important thing that we do, an important thing that we do well. Okay, on the community front, where's David Famella? Stand up quickly. David has joined Canonical as the congratulations. The as the official lead translation coordinator. So David will be working with our translation teams across, I think it's something like 100 different languages that we have teams translating, to see how we can raise the game in translations, how we can both improve the quality of translations in Ubuntu and the workflow that moves and shares those translations between other distributions and upstreams as well. So David will be working with the Rosetta team and also with our translation team leads. Archive Reorg, where is so David Holbach and Colin Watson have led the discussions on Archive Reorg and what that means for us both technically and socially. This is a very, very important shift, and I'd like to see it happen in 19. Essentially, this means rethinking the way we organize main and universe, rethinking the way we organize the developer community around those, making sure that we can give access to developers who have the right skills to do the right, to do cool stuff in Ubuntu, and to sort of accelerate that on-ramp for them. In a similar vein, distributed development. Who's tracking distributed development? Where is James Westby? Where is Jonathan Lang? Stand up. So these fine gentlemen are making it possible for us to essentially have full revision control of all changes made in Ubuntu. At the moment we track changes on an upload basis. There's an awesome movie of that, a Code Swarm movie of that done by Colin Watson, which we will put on for you at the end of the session, which shows the growth in the community and the growth in the pace of uploads. But we want to get even more fine-grained than that, and we want to open up participation. So we're going to leverage all of the infrastructure that's been built around Bazaar, all of the infrastructure that's been built around Bazaar code hosting and Launchpad, and make that available to the Ubuntu community so that all of our packages can be managed in Bazaar. You can have contributions coming in from people who don't actually have commit access using that infrastructure. And last, but not least, for me, you know, one of the most interesting initiatives, the idea of providing packages of the crack of the day, literally packages of tip of trunk of upstream, built either every commit or at least every day. So the idea is that we would have you would have an upstream, say Firefox, and there'd be a PPA somewhere where you could sort of effectively get today's Firefox code delivered to your Ubuntu desktop. The kernel team has done something like this, and it's been fantastic in terms of our interaction with upstream, because we were able to say, again, this is a bug that's been reported in Ubuntu, we can verify this bug in TIP, and that makes the bug that much more interesting to upstream developers. So figuring out how to build that, how to maintain that, and then how to create that full feedback loop effectively. We get more bugs and more information about Ubuntu from the community than the rest of all the major upstreams put together. We get more bugs filed against Ubuntu than OpenOffice plus GNOME plus KDE plus Firefox plus X, you name it. And the reason for that is just that we're the easiest way for people to get that code, but we're, you know, potentially up to 6 months out of date. So bringing that forward to literally today's code will make it that much more exciting for upstreams and make it that much easier for us to work with and talk to upstreams. So those are all the sessions that I'm tracking. There's a bunch more. I encourage you to look at the schedule, sign up for the specs, and make the very, very most of this fantastic week. All right, so on that note, back to John himself.
Okay, don't want to make this guy go away, he's quite cute. Curious how anyone got that photograph. So, I've shown this slide a few times before, it still hasn't appeared in the t-shirt. Which a few people wanted. So here we are. We're here for a really, really valuable chunk of time. You know, we spend the vast majority of our time in our community working online. We talk on IRC, we talk on the phone, we talk on mailing lists, but this is really valuable face time. We have some of the smartest people in the world here for a week, and our aim is to make absolute best use of this time across this range of different systems. And of course, this is just the start. Ubuntu has been deployed in many different platforms. But here we can build the strong foundation to the rest of the community. Now, each session, it weighs in at just under an hour. And some of you, who's new? Who is here for the first time? Yeah? Some, you, yeah. That's fantastic. So we have people able to apply for sponsorship for this UDS, and many people have come of their own accord. This UDS represented the most demand for people wanting to come. People requesting sponsorship, people asking how they could get here, asking how the hotel and the transport and everything else worked. I just want to tell a small story that I told at the last UDS. When I started working at Canonical, I got an email from this guy who lived in a remote part of Africa. And he told me that what he did, he was so passionate about Ubuntu that he would walk 3 or 4 hours to an internet cafe. He didn't own a computer. He walked 3 or 4 hours to that internet cafe. And he spent his own money to get online. And he'd have 1 hour, or I think maybe even 2 hours, but at least one, just 1 hour, it's a very short period of time in which he'd contribute to Ubuntu. And then he'd walk home again. Whoa. The Matrix is screwing with us. Is everything all right in the back of this audio guy? So we had, to me this really articulated what our role is. We need to get the most out of each hour. You know that guy who's walked 3 or 4 hours to get there and walked 3 or 4 hours to get back? We need to make sure that he spends his time wisely. And in the same vein, some of you have traveled, some of you have spent hours and hours in this position on a plane, getting there. And we want to make sure that we get absolute best use out of each hour. So keep these